looking at the average temperature for 2012, 55.3 degrees Fahrenheit for the lower 48 states. That is 3.3 degrees above the 20th century mean and puts it in uncharted territory in terms of an annual average temperature, one full degree above the 1998 record of 54.3 degrees. For the nation as a whole, in addition to that hottest year on record, it was the 15th driest year on record and the driest since 1988. Over the last 15 years, from 1998 to 2012, we have seen 7 of the 10 warmest U.S. years on record. In addition to 1998 and 2012, we also achieved top 10 rankings for warmth in 1999, 2001, and 3 in a row, 2005, 6, and 7. By the time we got into the late spring and the summer, soils were very dry, and a lot of the sun's energy went into heating up the ground and the adjacent air, and not into evaporation like we would see in a typical early summer pattern. So as we moved through the summer, a lot of the sun's energy went into heating rather than evaporation, and that contributed to the hottest month on record in July, and that carried on through the rest of the summer. Fortunately, we don't have La Nina right now, and that would be a contributor to even more likelihood of a very warm start to 2013. But I don't think anybody expects to see a complete repeat of what we saw in 2012, pretty much from January to December, warm and dry conditions. But we certainly have a lot of drought still left behind, and we're at great risk for another warm and dry year if things continue as we have.